Channel. Hi, my name is Bukola, and to my returning subscribers, thank you guys for coming back. You guys, another recap Monday. I don't want you to miss this recap Monday because this is the time that I have the opportunity to be able to answer you guys' questions in full details, because you know sometimes it might be so exhausting to type full or long explanation on some questions. So I'll advise you not to miss this recap. So if you like what we do here and you have not considered subscribing, please click on subscribe button, turn on the post notification as well, so that anytime I drop new videos you always get notified. So you guys, let's go straight into the recap. The very first question is, list out the ingredients used in the black soup. What this person is asking is the ingredient I use in the glowing black soup, and I think if you have watched that video, definitely you will have seen that I attached the ingredient to it and everything is there if you want to make it, because I've had people even text me about them making it, the pictures and all of that. So the ingredient is there, you don't need to like stress yourself, the ingredient is there. And if you want to add powders from what I talk about, from the four powders that I talk about that works for hyperpigmentation, you can always add it as well. So your powder is going to be the same measurement with your carrot powder or your rice powder, so that's just how you're going to do it. So the recipe is there, you can always check them out. So the second one is, what face cream can you recommend to be more lighter? If you want your face to be more lighter, you can work with Stay Young face cream. It's very good. Just make sure you're adding something that's going to help you with acne, because some people, when they try it out at first, they break out. So if you want to like try it out, put an anti reaction to it, you can put a Kigbu to it to make sure that it's not giving you acne basically. So, but it lightens the face more if that is what you want. The next one is, can I use pimento serum with Nature's Secret Carol lotion? Can I use it on my face as well? See, this is 2021. If you have the habit of using your body lotion on your face, I would advise you stop, unless it is a moisturizer that can both pass for the face and the body. But you see all these creams that you have to mix some serums with it and all of that, and you still have to use them on your face. And let's not say you're not even using an SPF, or don't even go there. So if you know you want to mix something with your body cream, mix it with your body cream and then don't use it on your face. Get a separate thing that you're going to be using for your face. Get a face kit, a face set that you're going to be using for your face. Don't use all these strong things on your face with that lotion anymore. It is a body lotion. Those people who produce it and wrote body lotion on it, they are not stupid. So don't put it on your face. So what you do is, whenever you want to mix something, because I want you to know that I'm not going to have a review about all these creams. Even most times, creams, I think I'm so backward when it comes to all these creams. So, but if you know that you want to use all these creams, make sure that you have checked reviews on them, you have checked online about people who have used them, listen to what they have to say about it, and when you are sure it's safe, then you can have a go at it. Pimento serum is a very good serum, and if you know that the Nature Secret you want to use is fine, is okay, nothing is wrong with it, then you can go ahead. Why not? You can add it to it. So next one is, I need a knuckle oil, can you make for me? You guys, I don't do production for sale at the moment. I don't do production for sale, and that's why I make tutorial videos, just to make it easier. The recipe is there just in case you need it. You guys, next question is, can I use the Ashanti scrub mixed on my face? Please, this Ashanti scrub contains, oh my goodness, you guys don't even know what just happened. But let's go on. Okay, this Ashanti scrub contains malic acid, glycolic acid, salicylic acid. I am not in any way, shape or form going to be advising you to use Ashanti scrub on your face. The one you mixed though, especially the one you've mixed, it is going to be too strong on your face. Your face might not need that. It might make your face so rough. So I'm going to be advising you guys not to use it on your face. Get a very mild scrub for your face. The skin on the face is so soft, you don't need something that strong. Your body is what you can be using all of those things on. Don't use it on your face. Don't even make a mistake to use it on your face. It might make your face very rough, because even alum, there are some alum powder that don't dissolve well until you leave it to like few days, or you use your mixer to mix it very well. It might make your face rough, so don't try it, don't do it. Next one is, can I add Labijani's tube to my face cream? If you have never seen Labijani's tube before, I want you to like check if you're interested in seeing it. Labijani's tube, when you open it, what is inside is like fashion fair content. How am I supposed to believe? If you are used to fashion fair content, when you put their cream on your hand, you see that it's slipping up as if there's water, something like that inside. That's how Labijani's tool cream is, that's too strong for the face. There is no reason why you want to put that on your face. It's not like you want to bleach your face. So I am not of that advice that you should go and add Labijanese tube into your face cream. Same way, I'm not going to tell you to add Passion Fair into your face cream because it is not safe. It is not safe. So don't add it into your face cream. I'm not going to advise you to add it to your face cream. And yeah, that's what I'm going to say because it's a strong bleaching tool cream. So I'm not advising you to add it into your face cream, basically. Next one is, I tried using black soap with salicylic acid, but I get more pimples and itches. Yes, there was a particular time when I talk about salicylic acid. If you are just using salicylic acid, you might notice that salicylic acid is like into your body. See, I'm going to be making a review on what I'm using on my face because I think if you watch my vlog, I talk about me battling with acne. I'm not going to talk about my problem, how I was able to like move from it itching my skin to a point where I no longer feel all those things anymore. But to be honest, salicylic acid might be so sensitive to some people, to a point that has happened to me before when I tried salicylic acid. All my face was just itching me. I was just scratching my face. And it happens like that if you know that you are using salicylic acid. So you might go for salicylic acid. If you want to use salicylic acid, I'll advise you go for the branded ones that maybe 2%, maybe 3%. Don't just go far. Unless you are sure that the one you are adding to your black soap, you measure it well and you know the percentage that you are adding. If not, I will advise you should not add it and just go for branded ones that has maybe 2%, then start building your skin to get used to it. Most of all these acid, your skin don't get used to them immediately. That's it. Even the very first time I tried glycolic acid, it was like an error for me, but I kept on trying. Like after 2 days each, I kept on trying, and now I'm used to it. I can even use it in the morning or in the evening, but it is always safe to use it in the evening, so don't get me wrong. So next question is, where can I get all these powders you mentioned that is good for hyperpigmentation? If I in Ibadan, yeah, I buy most of my powders from Iyisa Organics. I think I've mentioned Iyisa Organics countless times. So, but if you are not in Ibadan, you can as well text him. It ships to wherever, it ships everywhere. And if you're somebody who doesn't like paying for delivery fee or you like buying things around your vicinity, then you can check for any organic store closer to your site and you'll get it there. So you basically get to an organic store. So next one is, what can I use to mix New York lotion? I don't know anything about New York lotion. I'm going to be advising you to watch more videos about that to know how safe it is and all of that. I don't have a review about it. I don't even know what it looks like. So I'm sorry I can't answer that. Next one is it advisable to put vitamin C serum in scrub? I am not going to advise. If you want to put vitamin C serum in scrub, you can add it. But if you have ascorbic acid as well, you can work with ascorbic acid. Ascorbic acid, like the powder form, ascorbic acid is the same as vitamin C. I believe everybody knows that. So you can, if you have the powder form with you, you can always work with the powder form. The powder form is soluble in water, so I don't think there should be a problem in you dissolving that. And I think the shelf life is like 3 years from the date of production. So you can use the powder ascorbic acid instead of working with the serum. And if you want to work with the serum, you can work with the serum just that. I don't think I've ever done that before, but ascorbic acid can as well be added to your scrub in whatever way you want to do it. But I still prefer working with the powder. If you are formulating your scrub from scratch, I work with ascorbic acid, and you can work with ascorbic acid as well. And if you're someone that does not know how to do all those formulation and you want to work with serum, then fine, you can work with serum. If you don't know how to formulate and you want to work with serum, then it's fine, you can work with the serum. So you guys, these are the questions that I've been able to like bring out till, I think I wrote this thing last night before I sleep. This is 3 a.m. and please guys, see, please click on subscribe button, turn on your post notification, and always make sure that you check out my videos as well. So thank you guys so much for coming on my channel today. I will definitely see you guys in my next video. Bye.